everyone, and a very warm welcome to Doubles Tuesday. So guys, in our previous session, we have covered that how we can use group by. In our today's session, we are going to talk about merge, join and concatenate. So if you want to merge two data frames, you want to join it, you want to apply different kinds of joins like inner join, left join, outer join. In that case, we can use merge, concatenate. In that case, we can use several methods in pandas. We will be learning about them in our today's video. So let's have a look on guys at how it can be done. First of all, I'll import pandas as td. Once we have imported pandas, let's create a data frame. So for that, I'll be having dictionary one. Dictionary one is equals to, in this dictionary, I'm going to keep the data of employees. So first of all, the first thing would be the employee ID. Here I'll be adding some names and let's also put it inside a list. And lastly, David. Actually, these are names. So instead of employee, let me just copy this quickly. And employee ID would be double, maybe one, or you can write EMP1, comma, EMP2, comma, EMP3, and lastly, EMP4. These are the employee IDs. The names goes like the names that we wrote by mistake previously. And lastly, I want to add your gender as well. So I'll be giving here gender, that gender equals, and I'll create a list again. So the first one is male, the second one is male, third one is female, and lastly the fourth one is male again. Okay, this is our dictionary one, which has the employee basic details, what are their employee ID, their names, and lastly we have the gender. Now I'm adding another dictionary over here, that is dictionary 2. This dictionary 2 has another kind of data. For let's say it has again the employee ID, because employee ID will be the major key which will join both of them. So to join, to merge, to concatenate, it is very important that one of the columns should be similar in both of them. For example, how it happens in databases, that order ID is linked to order ID in different table, or customer ID is linked to different customer in different tables. So similarly, here also we have different tables, but we have employee ID in both of them, which is a common column which will allow us to join both of them. So this will be my employee ID. The next thing that I want to add over here is, let's say, department. So let's call it just DEP, and department would be, let's say, this guy is analyst, the second person is accountant, the third person is analyst again, and the fourth person is counselor. Lastly, I will be adding one more column. So this second dictionary contains the salary of all these employees. So I'll be adding salary as well. For that, I'll be creating a column named salary, and the values could go like 40,000. It's not an annual salary, but a monthly salary. Okay. So 40,000, the second one goes like 35,000, third one goes 45,000, and lastly the fourth one is, let's say, 23,000. Okay, let's create a data frame out of both of them. So this one will be DF1. DF1 is equals to pd.dataframe. So we need to create a data frame, actually capital D data frame. Inside this I'll be passing dictionary 1. And DF2 will have our dictionary 2. That's why I'll be writing pd.dataframe. And here I'll be passing dictionary 2. Let's run and see that. Let's print them. So for printing them, I'll be writing df1 / n, comma, df. As soon as I run it, / n is for the next line. So here we have our employee ID, names, gender. This has employee ID, department, and salary. If you want another space of one more line, we can add another / in any year. And as soon as I run it again, now it has a space in between. So this is both of our tables. Now what I want to merge it. How I want to merge it is, for that I'll be creating a variable called as m. M is equals to pd.merge. What do we need to merge? We need to merge data frame 1 and data frame 2. So in a square bracket, we'll be passing data frame 1, comma, df2. let's print the M and let's see how does it looks like. Also, let's give a space in between by writing print. In the merge, we will be passing our both the data frames, that is data frame 1 and data frame 2. Okay. And also, we will be passing that on the basis of what column we are going to merge it. For that, we will be writing on is equals to. So, on the basis of our employee ID, which is a common column in both of them, I will be merging it with the employee ID. Let's print M and let's see how does it looks like. So, as soon as I'll run it, you will now notice that these were our two tables which had employee ID 1234, employee ID 1234. And here we have all the data where we have 1234, the names, the gender, the department and salary in only one table. So, if you want to merge the data like this, in that way you can use merge. Merge comes along with different joins as well, that on the basis of what kind of join you want to add it. For example, inner join means that all the common data from both the tables will be displayed over here. So, I'll be giving another parameter over here that goes like how is equals to. First of all, let's talk about inner join. So, before I run for inner join means that all the data which is common in both the tables. Let's say there are more employees and in the employee details data, like this has the employee details like salary and the department. We only have data of employee 1. Similarly, suppose if we want to join the tables over here for joining, we need to make sure about one thing that no column should overlap. For example, we have employee ID which will overlap in both the cases. So that's why let's remove employee ID. Here we will be able to use the join method. How to use join method is very simple. Now that we don't have anything that is overlapping each other. For that, we can just simply write that instead of print, let's create a variable that j is equals to df1.join df2. Let's just print. Let's see how the output looks like. As soon as I'll run it, we'll get it in this way that it has joined it. But how it has joined it? On the basis of index 1, 2, 3, 4 and 0, 1, 2, 3. Sorry, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 0, 1, 2, 3. But what if the salary is of different people? So in that case, we need to provide an index over here. The index goes like index is equals to, let's call it 1, 2, 3, 4. And in here, I'll put it in this way that index is equals to 1, 5, 8, 4. And now if I run it, you will now see this is how it looks like. That we have index 1, 2, 3, 4 and whatever the salary was there and whatever the department salary was available in the second one, on the basis of that we have got the join over here. But you can also provide join on the basis of, you can just write over here that on the basis of index. Also you can join it like on the basis of inner and different kind of join. For that you just need to put a comma that how you need to join it, how is equals to, you want to join it, let's say inner join, and inner join will give us all the common data which is over here. So we have the common data again. Similarly, left and right and outer join works. So this is how the join method works. For the join method, it is very important that no column should overlap over here. Similarly, let's move ahead and talk about our concat function. Concat function works when you have two tables with similar kind of data. For example, if instead of dictionary 2 over here, let's just put this dictionary 2 in the comment. I'll copy this one. I'll paste it here. And this won't be our dictionary 1, but this will be our dictionary 2. Here, this will be our, because we have 1, 2, 3, 4 employees in this table, we will be having, let's say, 5, 6, 7, and 8 in this table. Okay, now let's change the name over here as well. The first one is, let's Ben. Second one is Jacob. Third is Lisa. And the fourth one is Jason. Okay, and now because this time I need to concatenate it, for that I will be writing, let's create a variable called as c is equals to df1 dot c is equals to df1 dot concat. For this we will be writing c is equals to pd dot concat, and in here we will be passing df1 and df2 in square bracket. So df1 and df2. Let's print it as well by writing print c. As soon as I'll run it, you can now see that both the this is table 1, this is table 2, and all the data of table 1 has been appended to table 2 over here. Indexes are also over here, so if you want you can remove the index as well. Choice is totally up to you. Only index were required in our join, In merge, you do not need any index. If you want, you can put, but in merge, we do not need index. In concat also, we do not need index, but if you want, you can do it. Similarly, if you want to add it on a different axis, in that case, you can just provide axis is equals to 1 and on the basis of join equals inner. So whatever will be the common data, that will come over here. Common data over here means that whatever has the same index. For example, over here 1, 1 and 4, 4 has the same index. That's why on 1 and 4 index, we have employee 1, John, who is male, and employee 5, Ben, who is male again, and employee 4, David, who is male, and employee 8, Jason, who is male. So this is how you can change the axis as well. So if you want to concatenate in this way that it should come below the other table, in that case, you can just directly use concat. If you want, it should align. If you want, it should horizontally align. In that case, you can use axis is equals to 1, join and inner join over here. So I hope you guys have no doubts in the questions on how we have used join, concat and merge. Stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.